Power windows can be used to create specific adjustments in specific areas, and today I want to show you how you can combine power windows with the HDR wheels to create very naturalistic adjustments to your shots. So just real quick, I have this shot here, which was shot on an Aria mirror, I believe. And so we have just a very simple DaVinci wide gamut workflow going. We've got a CST IDT node, which is transforming our footage from Arri to DaVinci wide gamut. We have our primaries nodes, which is just applying a quick balance to the shot. Then we have one of my LUTs here from my K83 pack, and this is the gold LUT. And this LUT is just applying a nice pre-built gold cinematic look to my shot. And then we have an ODT node, which is taking us out of that DaVinci wide gamut working color space and into our Rec. 709 display settings. I'm gonna go into my primaries node. I'm gonna select option S on my Mac keyboard to add a serial node. You can also right click and go to add node, add serial node. And I'm gonna rename this power window one. I usually always create an outside node. I've set my keyboard for that control to be option O. But if you don't have that command, then you can right click, go to add node and go to add outside node. And what I also like to do is to put all my power window nodes into a compound node. And you can do that by selecting all the nodes, right clicking on one of them and selecting create compound node. In this first node is where I'm going to create my first power window. Let's take a look at this shot aesthetically. The shot just feels off because all the brightness is right here on the edges. I want to bring out the eye. So I'm going to go back to my color page and then I'm going to add a circular power window. And then I'm going to feather it out. I always feather them out completely. You want the effects being applied to be as soft and as subtle as possible. Okay, and I'm just going to bring this up, feather it out again, and this is our selection. So I'm going to go into the HDR wheels, or actually, you know what? I'll go into the offset wheel and I'll bring it up. Let's say maybe there. Now, this isn't that bad of an actual adjustment, but I want to show you a more advanced way that you can go about this. And actually, power windows sometimes are this simple. And you know, within art, not just color grading, but art in general, simple is great. You know, the more you can do with less, the better. So this adjustment here actually isn't that bad. And if we, you know, just take a look, it doesn't look unnatural at all. Just that adjustment that we made doesn't look bad. Here it is before and here it is after. And we use the offset wheel for this. You could have also used the gamma wheel. You could have used also the global wheel in the HDR panels. You could have also used your curves adjustment. All those different tools are available for you to make this same type of adjustment. But now let me show you what you can do with HDR wheels. So I'm going to reset this adjustment. I'm going to leave my eye here as it is, and I'm going to go over to the HDR panels. If you look at the HDR wheels, they have this button here, and this is a button that you can click and hold, and it'll show you what luminance range in your shot this adjustment, in other words, this color wheel, is going to be affecting. So this shot has been taken from the Arri color space into a DaVinci wide gamut color space, and these HDR wheels are designed to work just naturally well with that color space. If I go over here to the shadow wheel and I click and hold here, I can see what luminance range in my shot, what areas I'm going to be affecting. So we're sort of combining two different selections, two different masks here. Another reason why I like working with the HDR wheels, particularly when creating masks, is that you can feather out the selection that the HDR wheels are creating. And you can do that by going here on this slider or this value down here. And we can just increase that. As I increase this, you see that this goes up as well. If you select Shift H, you'll be able to see your selection. And now you can just fine tune that selection. I don't need to get too specific with the feathering for this shot, so I'm just going to reset that. Now I'll go over to the dark to see what we're selecting here. And now that I've seen the different ranges that these different wheels are giving me, I can see that the shadow wheel is going to target the area that I care about the most, which is the iris. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the exposure value and I'm going to hit 1. Another reason why I like working with the HDR wheels and why you might like it as well is that you can use the values in here as actual camera stops. So increasing it by 1 would be this equivalent of increasing it by 1 stop of exposure. So you can do 0.33 and 0.66 for like 1/3. You can also do half or half a stop. I usually start by boosting it 1 stop and then seeing what happens and then I'll go from there. Taking a look at the shot, I'm gonna turn off the power window here, and I'm gonna hit before and after. And I'm loving what it's doing to the shot. It's grabbing all these dark areas and just bringing them up, and it looks natural. And it's also not affecting all these areas out here. And in this node here is where we are going to take care of these outer edges. So now that I've made my adjustments here, I'm gonna go into my second node. I'm gonna go over to my light HDR wheel to double check my selections. And I might actually go back to the shadow. No, yeah, it's gonna be the light wheel here. So let's go over to the lights and let's drop it by one stop and let's just see what happens there. And actually I'm liking that. I can already tell that if I dropped it by another stop, it would look way too unnatural. But you can also do this. You can drop it, you know, a little bit more specifically based on whatever range you want to affect, or you can go back to the global HDR wheel and make the adjustment there. So let's do it over here. Let's drop it by one stop. And I would say I don't really like how that looks. The difference that's happening here is that this adjustment is now affecting everything. And even though we do have a mask going on, it's very feathered out. So all these little dark areas are going to be affected as well. Whereas if we go to the light HDR wheel and we see the luminance range that this HDR wheel is going to affect, we can see here that it's going to avoid these dark spots, which we already adjusted to our liking. So we don't want to do that. We want to keep it a little bit more specific. So I'm going to reset this here and I'm going to go back to the light wheel and I'm going to drop it by one stop. And so here's where we started and here's where we are. And now you can see that we have relit the shot and it looks natural and we don't have any weird halos. Now, one more thing that I like to do is after all my power windows, I like to add a global node here. And then depending on what my image looks like based on these adjustments, I'll either adjust the saturation or the contrast. And I'm feeling like the contrast in the image was lost just a tiny bit. If we look at the waveform here, we can see just how much contrast there is before our adjustments. Now I'm going to turn it on. The waveform flattens out a little bit, so we do lose a little bit of contrast. Now, with this relighting of the scene, I'm going to add some of that contrast back in. Just a tiny bit. We'll change my pivot to 0.336. We are working in a DaVinci wide gamut color space, so here in the pivot tool, setting it to 0.336 will ensure that your contrast is pivoting around middle gray, which makes for a nice balanced contrast adjustment. Just gonna massage this around a little bit, and I'm kind of liking it right there, just a little bit more of pop. And if we select everything, turn it on, off, we can see our adjustments. Whatever selection you make with a power window with any shape, whether it's a square, a circle, or even a custom shape, you can take it a little bit further, get a little bit more specific by using the HDR wheels to target specific luminance ranges within the selection that you've created with a power window. One more thing, the quickest way to go back to your entire node tree is to just click right here on this gray bar once, and that'll take you back. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next one.